Hello children, I hope you all are safe and healthy. So today we will start our chapter 7, Animals Around Us. In this chapter, we will learn how animals are grouped according to their size, shape, the food they eat and how they are helpful. First of all, we will study about types of animals according to their size. So, first category is very big animals. The blue whale is the largest animal in water. The biggest living bird on the earth is ostrich, weighing about 150 kilograms. The largest land animal is the African elephant. It weighs about 6,000 kilograms. Giraffe is the tallest animal on the earth. Next category is big animals. They are smaller than the previous one. Examples are tiger, lion and bear. Third category is small animals. Rabbit, wolf, cat and dog are examples of small animals. Last category is very small animals. Ant, worms, mosquitoes are few examples. Animals differ in shape. They might have long bodies like snake and worms. Crocodile and lizards have also long bodies, but they have four short limbs that help them to crawl. Next is streamlined body. Most fish have a streamlined body. Streamlined means to make or design something with a smooth shape so that it can move in water or air easily. So, streamlined body of fishes help them to cut through water easily and their fins help them to move in water. Next is compact bodies. Animals like dog, horse and deer have compact bodies supported by their long forelimbs. Some animals don't have defined body shape, like sea animals looks like flowers, jellyfish looks like parachutes and starfish looks like stars. Next is very small bodies. Insects have very small bodies. Still, their body is divided into three parts and they have six legs. Hollow bones. Hollow bones means that have empty space inside. Birds have hollow bones and wings with feathers that help them to fly in air easily. Next topic is animals and their tails. Almost all animals have tails for different purposes. Examples are, dogs uses its tail to express emotions. It put its tail between its legs when it is scared and wags its tail when it is happy. Some animals like kangaroo and squirrel uses their tails to balance their body. Monkey uses its tail to swing from one branch to another. Fishes uses their tail fin to change directions while moving in water. Cow and buffalo use their tails to dry away the mosquitoes and flies that sit on them. Helpful animals. You have already studied in grade 2 that how animals are helpful to us. Let's take a quick review. Cow, buffalo and goat give milk. Hen and duck gives egg. Hen, goat and fish are a source of meat. Ox and bull help us to plug fields. Dog, cat and parrot are kept as pets. Honey is obtained from honeybees. Silk is obtained from silkworms. Sheep and camel gives us wool. Animals and their diet. As humans are differentiated into vegetarians and non-vegetarians as per their diet, animals are also categorized into four categories according to their diet. First category is herbivores. These are animals that eat only plants. Their teeth are specially designed to bite and chew plants. Cow and deer eat grass. Pigeons and sparrows eat grains. Parrot and squirrels eat nuts. And grasshoppers and earthworm eat leaves. Next category is carnivores. These are animals that eat the flesh of other animals after hunting. Carnivores are also called predators. The animals they kill and eat are called prey. Next category is omnivores. These are animals that eat both plants and the flesh of other animals. Their teeth help them to eat both type of food. Sparrow, crane, duck, bear, cockroaches, humans are some examples. Last category is scavengers. These are animals that live on dead and decaying food. Hyena, fox, and vultures are some examples. Our last topic is animals and their habitat. Habitat means the place where someone lives. Land animals can be found in different places. Camel is found in deserts. Cow and donkey are found in plains. Polar bear is found in polar regions. Rabbit and snake are found in holes in the ground. Monkey and squirrel lives on the trees. Birds and some insects fly in the air. Next is water animals. Some animals live in water like fish, octopus, starfish, dolphin, etc. They are also called aquatic animals. Their body helps them to move, breathe, eat, and hear in water. Last category is land and water animals. They are called as amphibians. Some animals live both on land and in water, like frog, crocodile, and turtle. Now, you can very well understand how animals vary in their shape, size, food habits, etc. So here we have completed our chapter 7. Thank you and take care.